kids, Miss Kulkarni here. In this video, let's talk about naming and formula writing for covalent compounds. So let's begin. So what exactly is a covalent compound? It is two or more non-metals coming together, and that makes it a covalent compound. So how do we begin with naming a covalent compound? Step number one, you look at the first non-metal which is present in the compound. And then you select a prefix. The prefix indicates how many atoms of the element are present in the compound. And we're going to talk about that just in a minute. There's a table given here which will tell you how do we select that prefix. But keep in mind, there is one exception for this, and that is if you have your beginning element with only one atom, you just leave it by itself. You do not use mono before that. So don't forget that. Okay. Then step number two, we look at the second nonmetal which is present, and we select the prefix using the table. The only difference is we are going to add "-ide to the ending part. So let's find out how we select the prefix. One atom, we put mono. If it's two, it's di. Three is tri, four is tetra, and you got it. As we go from 1 to 10, we just use simple geometrical terms to find out what should be the prefix. So let's begin with our real practice. Okay, first compound here is CO2. And the answer is given to you. The first element is carbon, so we put carbon there. The second element is oxygen. We made that into oxide. We added "-ide to that. Now, how did we get that letter "di"? Because we have two atoms of oxygen, so we made it dioxide. So let's look at the next one now. This is N2O3. N stands for nitrogen, so I'm going to write down that, and O is oxygen. When it becomes the last name, it is oxide, so I ended up that with oxide. Now how many nitrogen we have? Two. That means it is dinitrogen. And how many oxygen we have? Three. So we are going to add tri as a prefix there, and there you go, the answer is dinitrogen trioxide. Let's do next one. Next is S, stands for sulfur. Next is oxygen, so you got it, it'll be oxide. Now sulfur, we only have one atom, and remember our exception, we do not add mono if it's only one atom, so we leave it by itself as sulfur. When it comes to oxygen, there are three, so we are going to add tri before oxide. Let's do the next one. B is boron, and Br is bromine, but when we end up, we are going to write down bromide. How many boron? Only one, so we leave it by itself, no mono. And Br3, so we are going to add prefix tribromide. How about Si2? Br6. Si is silicon. And then Br is bromine, but it ends up with bromide. Let's take a count. How many silicon atoms? Two. So it will be disilicon. And then we got six bromine atoms. What is the prefix for six? It is hexa. So we got the answer disilicon hexabromide. Okay, let's work on the last one here. P4O10. P is phosphorus, and O is oxide. So how many phosphorus atoms we have? Four. So we are going to add tetraphosphorus. How many atoms of oxygen? 10. So 10 is decaoxide. And the answer is tetraphosphorus decaoxide. Now this is reverse. The name is given to you and you have to write down the formula. What I would recommend is circle those prefixes which you have and then write down every element. So di stands for 2 and pent stands for 5. The first element which you have is nitrogen, so we put nitrogen there. Second element oxide, which is actually oxygen, so we put O there. And then dinitrogen, so that went 2 here. And penta is 5, so 5 went with oxygen there. Alright, let's look at the next one. Chlorine monofluoride. So chlorine has nothing given, that means it's going to be 1 prefix. Then we have mono. Mono stands for 1. So pretty much we get chlorine 1 and then fluorine is also 1. We usually don't write the prefix 1, so it is ClF. Let's move on to the next one. Nitrogen trifluoride. Again, the first one prefix is only 1 because there is nothing given here. Tri means it will be 3. So that will be NF3. And the last one here, this is triboron. Tri stands for 3. And hexachloride, hexa stands for 6. We have first element boron and second element chlorine. And let's go back and use our prefixes. Triboron, that means it is B3. Hexachloride, that means it is 6. So it's B3Cl6. Alright, let's turn to organic covalent compounds now. Organic compounds, what do we mean by that? They all contain carbon and hydrogen. And now, there are 2 different types of organic covalent compounds. One is straight chain and the other is cyclic. Straight chain compounds have a formula which is CnH2n+2, and cyclic has a formula CnH2n, where n stands for any integer. So how do we name these compounds? It's simple. The first 4 are a little weird and we use a phrase, mom eats peanut butter. Mom, that goes with meth, eats, that's eth, peanut, that's for propane, and butter, that goes with butte. So for each of this, we are only going to add the last ending part as ane. So it will be methane, ethane, propane, butane, and beyond 4, it's simple. 5 stands for pent, hex, hept, so it will be heptane, octane, nonane, and so. Let's actually do some practice. The first compound here is octane and we have to find out the formula. Octa stands for 8. That means we are beginning with C8. The number of carbon atoms is 8. Now remember the formula which we had, it was CnH2n+2, because octane is a linear, a straight chain compound. So with that, hydrogen will be 2n+2, 8 times 2, 16+2, it will be 18, C8H18. Next is cyclopropane. Think about prop. Prop means how many carbon atoms? It is 3, so C3. If it's a cyclo, general formula is CnH2n, that's it. So how many hydrogen? 6. Cyclopentane. Penta stands for 5, so C is 5, and it's cyclo, so formula is same, CnH2n, that means it will be double of 5, which is 10. Heptane, there is no cyclo here, that means we are going to have formula CnH2n+2. Hepta stands for 7, so it's C7, and how many hydrogen? It's 7 times 2, 14+2, and that becomes 16. Octane is C8, because that's what octa is, and it's linear, straight chain, so hydrogen will be 8 times 2, 16, 16+2, 18. It's simple. Let's look at this reverse way. The formula is given and we have to write down the name. Look at the carbon atom number, C2. 2 is mom eats, eats is ethane. So definitely we have ethane. Now our job is to find out if it is a regular straight chain ethane or it's a cyclo. Look at the formula. If it's a cyclo, hydrogen will be double up to, which is not the case here. It's actually following the formula CnH2n plus 2. That means it's a straight chain alkane, which is ethane. Let's look at the next one. Coming at the number 10. 10 stands for deca, so it is decane. The number of hydrogen atoms is exactly double than carbon. That means it must be cyclo because the formula is Cn and H2n. Let's look at next one, 9. 9 is known, so it's nonane. The question is it cyclo or is it non-cyclo? 20 you obtain with the formula 2n plus 2, so it is simply a straight chain nonane. Look at this, 8 and 16. 8 times 2 is 16 and 8 stands for octa. So what we got is octane. And then we have to add cyclo before the name. And I think the last one, let's change it to C4H8. So if it's 4, that stands for butte. So it's butane. 8 is double than 4, so it'll be cyclobutane. So that's it, guys. Alright, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'll see you again in next video. Until then, bye-bye.